December 2014, I had an opportunity to go to Southeast Ohio to visit Mamerto Lagitan Tindongan. Mamerto had a dream. He saw an old bele, an Ifugao hut, where the roof is rotting in a familiar sight. And when he woke up, he took this dream as a message that maybe someday no one's gonna be interested about this ancient hut. Due to technological advancements of building structures, these ancient practices might be forgotten and vanish forever.
One of the dreams that, you know, I just saw this Ifugao hut that's getting ruined. Mm-hmm. And behind the hut was like exactly like this. That looks like a cellar. It's an abandoned place. But the Ifugao hut was still there. Mm-hmm. It's rotting, the roof are getting damaged, but still standing.
There are many reasons why he is building an Ifugao hut. And one of the fire that fuels it is a vivid dream.
I think what inspired me the most is the feeling inside me. The feeling of joy and happiness, and also the people who are being led to what I'm doing. And I also feel that there is real like awakening in them, so that's inspiring. Mm-hmm. You know, if I can help even just one person to transform or raise their consciousness, awareness of who they are, who they really are, and that will help them, you know, achieve fullness. Yeah. That has to be enough reason to keep going. I think my father there is about 30 years old, in his 30s at least.
Right here.
Yeah, he taught the researcher Conklin our dialect. So my father was his teacher. Mm-hmm. This is my family lineage. Schematic diagram of the Ifugao hut. How can you not have a close family? Even when you eat, you are in a circle. Mm-hmm. You are close to each other. You eat together. We don't have individual plates. We eat from the same container there. And that's our outdoor school. That's how you learn. As a child, you just observe how adults work. And then you have your own small work. That's real art. Mm-hmm. Because it's just making this for fun. And to make it look beautiful, he's enjoying every moment of it. Apo Ammeng's house. These are kengros. I'm going to use the bamboos that I planted to serve this purpose. But this is good proof here.
I also learned a little bit more about Lagitan's ancestors. Although he is very serious about these projects, he knows how to have a good time.
Oh, that's good.
by throwing spears.
That's a dead meat.
Chopping of firewood. Harnessing energy through Tai Chi movements. Ash Cave, one of the most sacred area in Ohio, where a lot of Native American lineage, like the Shawnee, perform their rituals. I asked Mamerto about the progress of the Ifugao Hut project.
I just wrap up the second stage after carving all the major joints. You know, I decided to take a break to sort of follow the tradition of not working continuously. The third stage, I will be working on the floor, the walling, and then the rafters, putting the roof. That will be next year. After that, we will celebrate with a ritual called Hokop. That's like before using the house to perform that ritual.
I am so thankful for all the beauty that I experienced in this place in a short time. Thank you, Ashke.
Do my honor, do my body, I do my with.
Very good.